We're now going to generalize how we index in memory when we try to access a matrix. So let this box here represent matrix A. And let's say that a typical entry in that matrix is alpha I comma j. And let's assume that this matrix is an M by N matrix. Now, in the previous unit, we came up with a way of indexing this, where we defined a macro alpha, which took as arguments I and J, and then translated that into where in memory this was located. And if the array was called A, then we had to index into J times M, the row size of the matrix, plus I. And that is how we would have to do it if we use column major order. Now, I always like to put parentheses around the I and the J, because you never quite know how this expands and whether order of computation is obeyed properly. All right, now, what we're going to see in the remainder of the course is that we actually typically want to work with submatrices of bigger matrices. What does that mean? What that means is that this matrix right here is more typically embedded in a much larger matrix like that. Right? And what does that mean? What that means is that columns of this larger matrix are stored contiguously, and therefore this formula does not represent how one should actually index into this entry right here. Okay? It's still going to be the case, typically, that this here is the address where A0 is stored. But now we need to do a little bit fancier indexing. Now, in the 1970s, or even earlier, when Fortran was used, the language Fortran would automatically do this translation for you. So it would have a built-in macro, essentially, for doing this. And to do that correctly, then, you would have to give the size of the array in which the matrix is embedded. And this was typically called the leading dimension of A, LDA. Now, what does that mean? Well, if you think about it, this address is still relative to the address A, or this location here is still relative to address A. But now, in order to get from one entry in the row to the next entry in the row, instead of going through M entries in memory, you go through the leading dimension of A entries in memory. Think of this as the stride that you need to take to stay within a row. So what does that mean? That means that we need to adjust this particular formula right now by inserting here the leading dimension of A instead.